Surya Sunera Vata Devarak Giya Do.
Hi, welcome to my channel, and this is episode 165 of our Gravetour of the Famous series. In this video, we return to Manila Memorial Park in search of notable individuals and famous celebrities interred in this part of Paranaque. Come, join us to remember, celebrate the life, and visit the final resting place of a veteran, media personality, sports journalist, commentator, and analyst that appeared in television and print media for more than 50 years. Located at the northern side of the park at the Golden Acre section, we found the final resting place of Ronnie Nathanielsz. Ronald Frederick William Nathanielsz was born on 2 November 1935 in Colombo, Sri Lanka. He was a veteran media personality and a sport journalist, commentator and analyst, and best remembered in his appearances as commentator in many local and international basketball and boxing matches, and most notably in Manny Pacquiao title fights. During his teens, Ronnie was training to become an Olympic boxer but was diagnosed of irregular heartbeat and therefore ended his boxing and Olympic dreams. In 1962, Ronnie and his Filipino wife and the rest of the family moved to the Philippines, and by 1965, he was working for a local radio station, DZHP. Ronnie also worked for Manila Standard Today and Philippine Daily Inquirer as sports columnist. In 1973, by the virtue of Presidential Decree 192, Ronnie was naturalized and was granted Filipino citizenship by then President Marcos. In 1975, he was appointed by Marcos to negotiate with a boxing organizer for the historic boxing event in 1975, Trila in Manila, the famous boxing match between Muhammad Ali and Joe Frazier.
Present the Trila in Manila. The blue corner from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, USA. Heavyweight champion of the world, Joe Frazier. From Louisville, Kentucky, USA. Heavyweight champion of the world, Muhammad Ali. Ali.
It's 15 rounds. The ring is 21 by 21, a rather large ring.
In the late 1970s, he became the news director of government TV station Maharlika Broadcasting System, Channel 4.
Making a statement such as that, you're really questioning the integrity of all these men?
No, it is the circumstance, Ronnie. Kamukha mo, impyado ka ng NMPC, maatakin pa si Marcos? Pwede.
No, no.
Pwede nga.
I will not attack the president. I have no quarrel with him.
Pwede nga.
Particular conditions set by either party for the departure of Minister of Senator Aquino?
I'm not aware of any.
Now, his condition, he calls for an operation on the heart, is that it?
According to three doctors who examined him, yes, he needs positively a bypass operation.
Taken, how long will he be away?
He calculate between 3 to 4 weeks. I am sure he will respect his own commitment.
Thank you, sir.
Boxing broadcaster Ronnie Nathanielsz has spent years following the career of Manny Pacquiao.
So, a place which is about probably one-fourth the size.
Really? Manny fight a long time ago.
Very long time ago.
He was 16. He just got to Manila.
Yes.
What was he like then?
He was wild. He threw punches from all directions. No science whatsoever. But he had power and he had guts, he had courage. He thought he will get where he is today and to do something that he thought he would be good at. And so what drove him initially was personal. After he grew in stature, country and people.
Struggled through it, as you can see the expression on his face. Then he enjoyed it. Joe Frazier suffered the most from his mouth, you know. The evening before, he told me he was going to knock out Frazier. So I thought he would do that because in the third round, he had Frazier in trouble. In the middle rounds, he got battered by some huge body shots by Frazier. That round, he wanted to quit. A couple of years ago, when I was doing a documentary, he said his idol was Muhammad Ali. And not just for his boxing skills, but also for his humility, his charitable work. And Manny Pacquiao does the same thing. Well, Manny was a former WBO welterweight champion. Now he told me yesterday after the game in the Araneta between Mahindra and the opposing team, where he scored a 3-point shot, unbelievable, just before halftime. And every time, strange thing, every time he touched the ball, the crowd would roar. You know, Grabe, like he was a real superstar, you know, like he was a Kobe Bryant or somebody like that. But he was good. He played well, played decently. After the game, he came to me, embraced me. Said he missed me, all of those usual pleasantries, you know, because we were very close.
In 2010 and at 75, Ronnie was diagnosed with prostate cancer but refused to have aggressive treatment. Instead, he continued covering sports in his remaining years. On the 3rd of November 2016, while en route to Las Vegas to cover the boxing match between Manny Pacquiao and Jesse Vargas, Ronnie experienced severe chest pains and was brought to a hospital in Burlingame, California. He died a few days later on 11th of November 2016 because of cardiac arrest. He was 81. My reflections on 50 years in the Philippines was a book written by Ronnie for a period of 7 years before his death. This was published in 2019, more than 2 years after his death.
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. I am Rachael Nathanielsz, the youngest daughter of Ronnie. As much as we would all like Dad to be here for his book launch, we couldn't bring him back to life, could we? However, I know that he's with us in spirit. I feel that. And on behalf of our family, sorry, I would like to thank all of you for coming here today. Your time and presence really mean a lot to us. Legendary Ronnie Nathanielsz couldn't make it today. I'll be the one to give you an overview of what his book is all about. Before I talk about the book, I'd like to say a few words about Dad. A little over 2 years ago, he left us to be with the Lord. He shared so many beautiful and fun memories with us that we will forever hold dear. More than a remarkable sports analyst and an exceptional journalist, he was a reliable friend and a loving father. He was known to many for his stern character and for telling it like it is. But to those closest to him, it was his incomparable sense of humor that made him unforgettable. And maybe his singing. We couldn't help but feel broken when he reached the finish line in the race called life. But we all believed he fought the good fight and he didn't finish well. He finished victorious.
In the next episodes, we will post the video of our recent visit of La Loma Catholic Cemetery in Caloocan and Libingan ng mga Biyag in Taguig. Later in this channel, we will also publish more Gravetour videos including Loyola Memorial Park in Paranaque and in Marikina. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe if you like my channel. See you in our next Gravetour of the Famous episodes.